On the Rutgers campus in New Brunswick today, students took advantage of the warm early autumn weather, most likely oblivious to the changes occurring around them, as the state's largest university took a big step towards updating its sexual harassment policy just hours after a report by NJ Advanced Media showed the university failed to investigate claims of sexual harassment that were older than 2 years, or the standard statute of limitations. Sue Livio wrote the story with Kelly Haber.
What really surprised us is that there were a group of university professors who had sort of seen it all, been through it all, and they were willing to come forward and challenge the university.
On behalf of former students from the late 90s and early 2000s, who, as the Me Too movement was exploding, came forward with their stories, only to be met by a shrug from university officials.
And they really wanted to be heard. They felt energized. And these professors were aghast that Rutgers was not looking at most of their complaints because the main reason being that the statute of limitations had been blown.
Even though the university's policy on the statute of limitations didn't differ much from, say, the state legislature's recently updated policy, Rutgers President Robert Barchi took the surprising step of unilaterally changing it within hours of the NJ Advanced Media report. As a university, we must constantly reassess our policies and procedures to make sure we are providing the best support and resources we can, wrote Barchi in a letter to the university's governing boards, adding that he had ordered a review of the Office of Employment Equity Policy. While that review continues, he wrote, today I directed that the investigatory policies of the OEE be updated immediately to remove the reference to a 2-year period for pursuing investigations.
There were some students who thought, well, if that's all it took, you know, we need to get out here more and speak more because that's going to get coverage and that's going to make change.
News of the change spread through a student demonstration last night, and at least some students today were calling it a win.
I know so many people who have complained about the counseling that they received after they got sexually assaulted, how the university totally dropped the ball in terms of that. So I think that it's a good step in the right direction, but there's a lot that needs to be done.
It's definitely created like a more open dialogue to talk about sexual harassment on campus, where maybe before it was kind of like a topic that people didn't really want to address.
The OEE review will look at staffing levels and training, as well as the overall university policy. Barchi said the review should be completed by the end of the month. In New Brunswick, I'm David Cruz, NJTV News.